all day long, mate. Easy, brother. What's up? Hook in the back, let's go. Yep, strongest pop, mate. What's up? Strongest pop, mate. What? Fucking strong, mate. Easy, brother. Come on, Sam. All day, mate. This is what you're born to do. All day. All day. Yeah. Come on, brother. Yeah. Woo!
I thought you said you want to be the best, but you don't act like you don't move like you. You wake up late, you sleep late, you don't study, you don't work out. You don't want this shit. And no one's gonna.
There's 1,000 other guys waiting in the wings who are obsessed with this game. Obsession is gonna be talent every time. You got all the talent in the world, but are you obsessed? Let's face it, it's you against you out there. When you walk on that court, you have to think, I am
the best ever. I'm the most brutal and vicious and most ruthless champion there's ever been. There's no one can stop me. Lynx is a conqueror. No, I'm Alexander. He's no Alexander. I'm the best ever.
Tired of having chicken legs because you don't know how to structure your leg workouts? This is how to optimally perform a 6-exercise leg day for Hive Trophy. The last 2 exercises are where the fun happens. First, you need to train calves.
I train calves at the end of my session because they're the least important.
But in reality, you don't do it and head straight to the changing room. Train at maximum intensity and keep reps slow. After calves, perform a lying hamstring curl to fatigue them in the shortened position where most mechanically weak. Next, the opposite knee flexor movement, the leg extension. You can even superset this with a sissy squat if you're feeling extra optimal. Then complete a set on the adductor machine to bias the often neglected leg muscles and prepare them for the heavy compounds. Now it's time for the almighty squat pattern. I'd advise choosing a hack squat, pendulum, or Smith machine over the barbell squat. But as long as you can get a deep range of motion, happy days. To finish off the brutal session, we have one set on the leg press. Get as deep as possible, and if you can walk after this set, you need to up your intensity. Follow for more.
Guys staring in the gym has gone too far. And now we wait.
Icing your ball sack can apparently increase your testosterone. If you're an OG, you'll remember I did this back in like 2022. I did it every day, but I didn't measure the increase. But now I've got what my actual level is. That's about 710 nanomoles per deciliter. Which is actually pretty alright, I'm on like the upper end of normal. But in the name of science, for the next 30 days, I'm going to ice my ball sack 3 times a day for 20 minutes and see if it makes a difference. I have already started, I've got peas down my pants. Remember last time I did this, I had about like 50 messages every day being like, bro, have you iced your balls yet? If you want to remind me, do it, but I won't be sending you pictures to prove it this time.
63 high, coming in on target. Than that, son. Heat is life.
care if you're 15 years old, 25 years old, 65 years old. Today is the youngest you will be for the rest of your life. Now you have two options. You can let life pass you by, or you can go with my option. You can grab life by the fucking throat and get after it every single day.
Right, boys, come with me to the Arnold UK event for day one. Trust me, you're not going to want to miss any of the content in this video. There was some epic moments. So we arrived and straight away the energy was insane. I've never been in a room with more testosterone in my life. Right away we headed straight over to the powerlifting. We watched this Norwegian powerlifter pull like 350 kilos, which is a world record for his weight class. It was absolutely insane, like really. Then we headed to Applied Nutrition stand to try and get some free supplements, and I managed to catch some. We got some free supplements, we headed over and we found two of my friends that actually were getting an autograph and also a photo with the legend Noel Diesel, so this was very cool. I decided to film it because I knew it meant a lot to them. And then we saw the big boy, we saw Arnie, which was just insane, like this was nuts. After seeing the GOAT Arnold, I actually ended up in a Young LA bench competition against an absolute beast. I came second out of five or six people, so I'll take it, but hats off to the first guy. What's that? Is it a bird? Is it a plane? No, it's Ronnie Coleman zipping around in his electrolyzed wheelchair. This was just unreal to see. Like, it's a shame to see Ronnie in this state, but awesome. If you didn't think my chest was fried enough, I actually ended up in another bench competition. This one actually being none other than the Gym Reapers. So having Baker or the Gym Reaper spot me on this was absolutely insane. So yeah, I managed about 22, 23 reps of this. It was an 80% body weight challenge on the bench, so not too bad, but I certainly could have done better. Very cool little interaction with Baker at the end. Here we hit some chest flies in the amazing equipment that they had in the NEC. So of course, little chest session with some pec deck. Absolutely loved this. Then unexpectedly, we ran into Sam Sulek, which was pretty cool. He was signing and taking pictures with people, so I had to record the moment. If you enjoyed day one of me at the UK Arnold, make sure to drop a follow and also give this video a like. Make sure to tune in for tomorrow's episode as well, because we're here Saturday and Sunday.
Men are not meant to be dominant. Men are meant to be submissive.
Life's too short to exercise. I'm just going to be honest. There are so many better things to do than exercise.
Men can cry. You so it's okay to be weak.
Shut up, bitch!
I was the first Conor McGregor. I was Conor McNigger.